had that outlaw rebel edge from the start.
He was somebody who just had the look. He had that ragged edge that he could put in his voice, and it was from just plain old hell raising.
He sang those songs, you know, he lived it, and he did live it.
Somebody who probably had a lot of demons. He drank and smoked and did anything you could probably do, and he sang about it.
Living on the edge and often on the street, Paycheck drank his way through numerous record deals during the 60s, and then in 1977, he recorded his only number one hit, a blue-collar anthem written by fellow outlaw David Allan Coe.
Take this job and shove it.
Boy, when Take This Job and Shove It came out, it was like a whirlwind.
Johnny Paycheck was perfect for that song because, you know, I could just picture him, you know, with his attitude, just walking in there and telling his boss, you know, here, just take this job and shove it.
By 85, Paycheck's explosive temper and a belly full of booze finally got the better of him. He pulled out his Saturday night special in Ohio Honky Tonk and let her rip.
That bullet went in right above my eyebrow. Come out up here.
That's back when I used to drink, you know. And if I hadn't been drinking, I wouldn't have been in them places.
Paycheck was sentenced to 9 years for aggravated assault and pardoned in 1991 only after serving two. He was welcomed back by his brother-in-arms, Waylon Jennings and George Jones.
You're looking great.
How's it feel to be out now?
I guess that's as close to heaven as I'm ever going to get.
Johnny Paycheck was an outlaw just because he just couldn't help it. It was just in his blood.
If I was all the things they said I was, I wouldn't have time to do nothing.
Take this job and show it.